السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، وأصلي وأسلم على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين، نبينا وحبيبنا وقرة أعيننا محمد بن عبد الله، عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه أفضل الصلاة وأتم التسليم، أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. وقال تعالى في كتابه العزيز بعد: أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. All praise and thanks be to Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who is our creator, sustainer, nourisher, protector and curer. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to shower His choicest of blessings and salutations upon our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his family members, his companions, and all those who tread upon his path with utmost sincerity until the day of Qiyamah. O people of Gaza, we are with you in your pain and we haven't forgotten you. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alleviate the suffering of the people of Gaza. May He the Almighty grant them the highest stations in Jannah, and may He accept them and may He fill their hearts with strong, unwavering patience to go through the hard times that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has decreed for them. Hadith is in Muslim. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is reported to have said, مثل المؤمنين في توادهم وتراحمهم وتعاطفهم مثل الجسد الواحد. الله أكبر. The example or the parable of the believers in terms of their compassion towards one another, in terms of their love towards one another, in terms of their mercy towards one another is like one body. Is like one body. إذا اشتكى منه عضو تداعى له سائر الجسد بالسهر والحمى. الله أكبر. Even if one limb complains of pain, then the whole body aches back in response. الله أكبر. The whole body aches back in response just for the complaining of one limb of pain. الله أكبر. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive all of our sins and may He accept our deeds. My dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, if you were to take the trials that we personally went in the past few weeks in comparison to the trials that our brethren in Gaza, in Palestine are currently going through, it's nothing. Wallahi, it's nothing. Allahu Akbar. The media is fooling us, is blinding us, and blinding us away from the truth and the reality, keeping us busy and dazzling us with fancy games of football and cricket, whilst innocent men, women and children are being butchered, massacred and killed. Allahu Akbar. And nevertheless, these are all from the signs of an extremely important day that we are headed at a very rapid pace. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is also reported to have said that the last hour, along the lines of these words, that the last day, the last hour will not take place until excessive haraj will start taking place. Allahu Akbar. And excessive haraj is excessive killing, excessive massacres will start taking place. These are all signs that the day of Qiyamah, that the judgment day is extremely close, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is also reported to have said, along the lines of these words, that nations will gather from all four corners. Nations will gather and they will start inviting one another, just as how they would invite one another to partake of a meal. Allahu Akbar. Just as how they would invite one another to partake of a meal to eliminate or to destroy the Muslim Ummah. Allahu Akbar. The Sahaba Ridwanullahi Ta'ala alayhi majma'in then asked Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Ya Rasulullah, will we be few in number at that time? Will our numbers be few at that time? To which Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam replied, that nay, you will be like the froth of the sea. You will be in vast numbers, in huge numbers. You will be like the froth of the sea. But the fear for the Muslims will be taken away from the enemies of Islam. And wahan will be cast in the hearts of the Muslims. Allahu Akbar. Wahan in the sense, love for this materialistic worldly life, for this materialistic dunya, and the fear to meet death. This will be cast in the hearts of the Muslims. Allahu Akbar. It is upon us not to latch ourselves onto this worldly life, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, because inevitably, we are going to leave it very soon. Very soon and traverse on to the eternal Akhirah, where we will, insha'Allah ta'ala, enjoy perpetual and eternal bliss with the help of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The more we remember death, the more we remember death, just as how Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is reported to have said, and hadith is in Tirmidhi, أَكْثِرُوا ذِكْرَ هَذِي مِنْ لَذَّاتِ Allahu Akbar. Make excessive remembrance of the terminator of pleasures. Make excessive remembrance of the destroyer of pleasures. The more we remember death, it shatters the fake veils of pleasure that this dunya adorns herself with. The more we remember death, because inevitably we are going to leave this dunya and head to our creator, our powerful maker. You have media reports that state that for the past 3 days, even though the numbers are manipulated and you can't believe it, but still the numbers are high. For the past 3 days, for just the past 3 days, almost around 100 Palestinians have been killed, Allahu Akbar. Almost about 100 of them, just for the past 3 days. And almost around 600 of them are very badly injured. They are raining missiles down on Gaza. They are raining missiles down on Gaza. Their operations are basically, if they have 1,000 targets, if they have 1,000 targets, that is going to result in 1,000 deafening, bowel-shattering explosions all over the city. Allahu Akbar. 1,000 explosions killing so many civilians, killing so many innocent men, women and children. From this we understand, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, that the day of Qiyamah is very close and that we need to be ready to meet our powerful maker. We need to keep questioning ourselves. Are we ready to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Will we be in a state that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be pleased with us if we were to meet Him today? Because on that day, my dear brothers in Islam, on the day of judgment, a scale will be put up, Allahu Akbar. A scale will be put up, and our good deeds and our evil deeds will be weighed on that day. And if the scale tips towards the good deeds, then alhamdulillah, we will be successful. Just as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala states in the Noble Quran, فَأَمَّا مَنْ أُوْتِيَ كِتَابَهُ بِيَمِينِهِ فَيَقُولُ هَا أُمُقْرَأُ كِتَابِيًا. As for the one who is given his book of records on his right hand, he will go around crying out to the people, فَأَمَّا مَنْ أُوْتِيَ كِتَابَهُ بِيَمِينِهِ فَيَقُولُ هَا أُمُقْرَأُ كِتَابِيَا. Here is my book, read it, here is my book. Because he will be so happy that he is victorious on that day, Allahu Akbar. But as for the person who gets his book of records on his left hand, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us all. وَأَمَّا مَنْ أُوْتِيَ كِتَابَهُ بِشِمَالٍ فيقول يا ليتني لم أوت كتابيا. As for the person who gets his book on his left hand, he will say, woe be unto me, how I wish that I was not given this book, Allahu Akbar. Woe be unto me, because he will be amazed as he opens his book, everything will be recorded, Allahu Akbar. And don't question the might and the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as to how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to record all of our deeds. I mentioned this even last night. It is not a big deal for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to have all of our records in one place. If you were to take about 20 or 30 years back, a floppy disk 1.44 MB was this big. But today, in today's times, you can have one tiny chip, 1 terabyte, 1,000 GBs, 1,000 gigabytes in your pocket. And you can have scores of books, scores of PDF files with you right now, and no one would know. You can have high quality images, thousands of full HD videos with you, and no one would know. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who gave man the intellect to invent that, do you think it is difficult for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to record all of our deeds? Allahu Akbar. Every single statement of ours, every single word that we articulate, every single deed that comes out from our limbs will be recorded and will be used to testify for us or against us on that day. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ease our questioning on that day. So nevertheless, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, like I said, let us avoid al-wahan. Let us not latch ourselves onto this dunya. Let us not fill our hearts with hubbu dunya, with the love for this worldly life. We can amass millions, we can build mansions, we can run around in expensive motor vehicles, which I'm not saying is haram. But nevertheless, we need to get our priorities straight. Are we going to be here in this dunya forever and ever? Are we going to live here permanently? None of us can guarantee that we would walk out of the masjid today. Allahu Akbar. This is how temporary and how unstable the life of this dunya is. Allahu Akbar. So let us prepare for the permanent and eternal akhirah. Let me mention to you all a story. A story of a righteous king. He was known as Harun al-Rashid, rahimahullah. On his deathbed, he was a powerful king who owned palaces, wealth, horses, slaves, name it. He had all of the luxuries on this world. On his deathbed, he cries out. Now he's seriously sick, seriously ill. He cries out to his ministers, to his subjects, "I wish to see my grave. Please take me to my grave and show me my grave." Allahu Akbar. The ministers, they advised him against it. They told him, "No, it might make you even more negative. Oh, respected king, don't do it." To which he insists, "Take it as my last wish. I wish to see my grave." To which they finally agreed and they take him to his grave. Allahu Akbar. The minute he saw that dark pit in the ground, he looks back and looks at his glittering palaces. He looks back and looks at his horses. He looks back and look at his slaves, everything that he owns. He looks at his clothes, the royalty, what he's wearing, the brocade and the design and the embroidery. And then he looks at that dark pit in the ground. Allahu Akbar. And then he recites the following verses. مَا أَغْنَى عَنِّي مَالِيًا مَا أَغْنَى عَنِّي مَالِيًا My wealth has not benefited me. My wealth has not availed me. You know, you may be decked with designer wear from head to toe. You may be riding in the most expensive motor vehicle. You may be living in a mansion overlooking a beautiful river. But at the end of the day, you will have to leave all of that and go into that pit with just one white shroud, which at times may be purchased by someone else. If you have already bought your shroud and kept it ready for you. What is the point of this dunya, my dear brothers in Islam? What is the point if we are going to leave everything and go? And the only thing that will come with us to that grave will be our good deeds, our a'malu salihat. Allahu Akbar. He goes on to recite, Halaka anni sultaniyan, halaka anni sultaniyan. My authority, my dominion, my kingdom has perished from me. Allahu Akbar. He was the king, but then now he's going to enter that pit as nothing other than a slave of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You can be the king, you can be the ruler, you can be the king of the world. It doesn't matter. Malakul Maut is inevitably going to come visit you. Allahu Akbar. And then he raises his hands, he starts weeping and he cries out to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ya man la yazul mulkum irham man qad zal mulkum ya man la yazul mulkum irham man qad zal mulkum O the one whose kingdom will never ever perish. O the one whose dominion will never ever perish. Allahu Akbar. Allah, the King of all kings. Irham man qad zala mulku. Have mercy upon the slave whose kingdom has now been taken away from him. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. My dear brothers in Islam, this is the reality of this life. So let us prepare. Let us prepare for Akhirah. For if we are prepared, it really doesn't matter how death comes to us. Allahu Akbar. It really doesn't matter. It doesn't matter how death comes to us or when death comes to us. Because we are ready to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we would leave this dunya smiling, light-hearted, rejoicing and excited to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and enjoy the blessings of Akhirah, of Jannah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive all of our sins. And may He the Almighty accept our good deeds. And may He the Almighty help us to make the best out of this month of Ramadan, as if it is our last month of Ramadan. May He the Almighty alleviate the sufferings that the Muslim Ummah is going through. May He help the brothers in Gaza. May He alleviate their sufferings. May He ease their pain. May He fill their hearts with strong, unwavering patience. May He fill their hearts with taqwa. May He accept the shuhada from them. And may He grant them the highest darajas in Jannah. And may He grant us too the highest darajas in Jannah. May He the Almighty unite all of us, just as how He united us here this afternoon in the gardens of Jannah with our beloved Master Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Wa akhir da'wa yani alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.